Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. First things first, next week's video will be our monthly Q&A. So, please send me your questions either in the comments or in the Ask Dao Yi channel of the Dao Yi Discord or email me for anonymity. Before we proceed to the main topic for today, let's get high on tea. This week's tea is an amazing green tea, Bi Luo Chun. Bi Luo Chun tea has a history worth about 1,000 years. This tea grows in Dongting Shan or Dongting Mountain in Suzhou City, Jiangsu Province. Due to its long history and unique flavor, Bi Luo Chun is one of the top 10 teas in China. The name Bi Luo Chun consists of three characters. Bi means green, Luo means snail because the processed tea leaf look like a snail, and Chun means spring because this tea should be harvested in the early spring. So the literal translation of Bi Luo Chun is green snail in spring. Of course, there are many origin stories behind the name of the tea. Many types of Chinese tea have different legendary stories behind their names, and this tea is no exception. For example, one popular story behind this name goes that once Kangxi, one of the Qing Dynasty emperors, traveled to Dongting Shan, he was impressed by the strong, fresh fragrance of this tea after drinking it. After inquiring about the name of the tea, he named the tea formerly called Scary Fragrance to Bi Luo Chun, since the name Scary Fragrance did not sound nice, even though it meant that the fragrance of the tea was so strong that people felt scared of it. Bi Luo Chun is a green tea, high in polyphenols and good for health. This is another tea that people drink for its great flavor, not only for its health benefits. Compared to other teas that I have introduced in the last few weeks, the Bi Luo Chun tea leaf is very small. For example, a pound of processed Bi Luo Chun tea needs 30,000 to 40,000 leaves. Since the tea leaf is so tender, you can see white hair on the dried tea leaf. To brew Bi Luo Chun, you need to use Shang Tou Fa or add tea on the top of the water method. The best water temperature for Bi Luo Chun is about 80 to 85 degrees Celsius. So, you add hot water a bit higher than 80 degrees into a cup. The reason to use water higher than 80 degrees is that the cup will cool the water down automatically. Then you add the tea leaves on the top of the water and wait for about 3 minutes before drinking it. You can brew the same tea for about 3 times each time, but you should use water at about 50 degrees Celsius after the first brew. I have a can of Bi Luo Chun, and I only drink this with friends since good Bi Luo Chun is rare. This is the tea leaf. Bi Luo Chun tea has a strong, fresh, and slightly sweet flavor. If you find your Bi Luo Chun to be bitter in taste and lacking the freshness of a flavor, it is very likely that your Bi Luo Chun did not originate in the Dongting Mountain area. Different types of teas grow in different regions and thus have different flavors. Share your Bi Luo Chun experience in the comments and also let me know what tea you are enjoying this week. Now, let's get on with the topic for today. In a couple of prior videos titled Internal Style Concept 31, Li Shen Zhong Zheng, and Internal Style Concept 45, Tai Qi Imagery, Tai He Yuan Qi, I had talked about the importance of correctly understanding the meaning of Li Shen Zhong Zheng, or body straightness. I had also briefly mentioned the concept of Xie Zhong Yu Zheng, or straightness in leaning motion. Let's replay that part first. Bear in mind, there is an interesting concept, Xie Zhong Yu Zheng, or straightness in a leaning motion. Briefly speaking, the straight motion reflects Li Shen Zhong Zheng, even in a leaning posture. Take a look at those photos. The first photo is Wu Jianquan, Wu Style Tai Chi founder. The second photo is of Yang Chengfu, creator of the big frame Yang Style Tai Chi. The third photo is of Tian Xiuchen, one of the most important students of Chen Fa Ke. These are just some of the most noteworthy examples. All of those photos demonstrate the concept of Xie Zhong Yu Zheng. So, that was a brief introduction to Xie Zhong Yu Zheng in an old video. It is an advanced topic, and in today's video, we will dive deep into it. Topics covered in today's video include: first, balance in Chinese culture. Second, martial art and Xie Zhong Yu Zheng. Third, practice of Xie Zhong Yu Zheng. Fourth, principles of Xie Zhong Yu Zheng. Fifth, misperception of Xie Zhong Yu Zheng. Sixth, demonstration. Seven, correction of students' practice. Eight, takeaways. So, without any further ado, let's get started. First, balance in Chinese culture. Balance or 平衡is a key concept in ancient Chinese philosophy. For example, yin yang theory is a philosophical notion that says through a process of harmonization, a constant dynamic balance between all things can be created and maintained in equilibrium. 和谐 or harmony is a commonly used term to describe that state of balance. At the individual level, balance is achieved through self-discipline, high moral value, and avoiding unnecessary physical force, using it only as the last resort. When applied to art, balance and harmony do not necessarily mean a physical symmetrical structure. Instead, Chinese aesthetics really emphasize the asymmetrical approach, which is the result of a dynamically balanced state of being. In a prior video titled Internal Style Concept 28, 气韵生动, I introduced 气韵生动 as the concept expressing the formlessness and intangibility of energy and its resonance. However, this formlessness and intangibility are based on form and tangibility, which can be used to explain the concept of dynamic balance. For example, Chinese painters apply different image structures compared to Western painters. Again, traditional Chinese artistic aesthetics focuses more on dynamic balance. I'd like to use Chinese calligraphy to explain this a bit further. In Chinese calligraphy, the artistic expression of understanding the aesthetic standard is mainly based on asymmetrical features of work. Each brush stroke is clearly articulated through a complex series of brush movements, guided by the artist's mind, no matter what style. You can sense it by observing those outstanding historical masterpieces. Among those calligraphy works, some styles such as cursive script and running script by nature are very dynamic. Some other styles such as regular script or kai shu, which usually look very straight in terms of its stroke shape, are dynamic as well. For example, most of the horizontal strokes have a slightly uplifting angle on the right side of a character. Please pay attention to some commonly used characters and pay special attention to the right upward tendency of each character. However, the secret is that even though there are multiple horizontal strokes that maintain a right upward uplifting angle, there is also an important stroke to balance the upward tendency with a reverse approach, which is the artistic technique to maintain a dynamic balance. Now, you may think that Chinese calligraphers are indeed playing with people's minds in the process of creating such a balanced feeling in art appreciation. Well, maybe you are right. However, it is just one of the artistic expressions towards creating a dynamic balance in calligraphy. Or else, it would not be called calligraphy. To summarize, balance in Chinese culture means dynamic balance and not merely maintaining a physical symmetry. So, how is this concept applied in martial art training? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 2, martial art and xie zhong yu zheng. As mentioned in prior videos, the term xie zhong yu zheng implies that in martial art practice, you have to understand the correct meaning of the word zheng or straightness. Furthermore, understanding the term xie or leaning motion is important as well. So in this section, I will focus on explaining them. I recommend watching the two prior videos introducing Li Shen Zhong Zheng and Tai He Yuan Qi, and only then resuming this video to get a better understanding of Xie Zhong Yu Zheng. Now, my first question to you is straightness about physical balance? Let me also answer it. No, it's not. Li Shen Zhong Zheng is the ability to maintain body balance in martial practice, not merely the upright body structure. In a dynamic state, for example, a combat or self-defense situation, maintaining a fully upright body is almost impossible. Now you may wonder why in practice we have to emphasize the body's straightness. Well, that is because the body straightness structure is the easiest way to sense the feeling of balance. To understand this better, let's read Chen Xin's explanation of straightness in his Chen Style Tai Chi book. Chen Xin said, quote, 不偏不倚非行迹之谓, 乃神自然德中之谓也。 End quote. Translation: The term without leaning and deviation does not talk about body movements. It talks about the spirit and the mind in a naturally balanced state. End translation. From Chen Xin's writing, we can see that the energetic feeling of balance is the right concept and not the physical movements in a mechanically symmetrical state. Many Wu style Tai Chi practitioners prefer using the term 斜中预正 or straightness in a leaning motion to express the concept of dynamic balance. Of course, some other Wu style Tai Chi practitioners are against the adoption of this term since the character 斜 or leaning is not a highly appreciated word in the Tai Chi community. The reason is very simple. At face value, leaning seems to violate the concept of 立身中正. Actually, let's first define the term leaning. I define leaning as the special state of 立身中正, a state that maintains the spirit of straightness in terms of energy, but with a physically leaning body structure. With this definition in mind, the term straightness in a leaning motion is totally correct in expressing this martial concept. Before going any further, let me introduce three Chinese characters, 斜, yang, and 情. The upper body leaning sideways is called 斜. The upper body leaning forward is called 情. And the upper body leaning backward is called 阳. 阳, in this case, does not mean the same as my family name. My family name, 阳, is pronounced in the second tone, and the 阳, which means backward leaning, is pronounced in the third tone. Unless you are practicing a specific movement such as this one. Backward leaning is not a good body structure according to traditional standards. Then, how about 斜 and 倾, or side and forward leaning? Let's discuss. Again, let's check this famous 斜飞式 or oblique flying posture picture of Wu Jianquan, the founder of Wu style Tai Chi.In his structure, the left side body leaning motion is balanced by the downward pushing motion of the right hand and arm, while the right side body oversinking energy is balanced by the uplifting motion of the left arm and hand. Give it a try, and I'm sure you will sense what I mean here.Martial art practice needs to be felt physically in order to correctly understand the theory. So, this photo of Wu Jianquan reflects the concept of 斜中预正. Therefore, left and right leaning motion is perfectly correct if you can dynamically maintain balance. By definition, forward leaning is called 情, not 斜, but very often people use them interchangeably. As a result, forward leaning is considered an incorrect body structure as well by some martial artists. Forward leaning motion is absolutely necessary if you practice traditional 形意, no matter what branch. However,modern wushu practice, with its mechanically vertical up body structure, has wrongly influenced some martial artists to perceive it as the right body structure. Many years ago in China, A few people with modern Wushu-influenced practices criticized my Xingyi posture. But this type of misunderstanding disappeared after I published a lot of materials explaining the reason for this type of posture in traditional practice. Also, I have explained and clarified the Wushu-influenced mistakes in some prior videos already. So, generally speaking, a forward-leaning body is the right body structure in traditional Xingyi practice. In Tai Chi practice, many postures in almost all the traditional Tai Chi styles always have a forward-leaning motion in certain foot pose positions. Let's look at some relevant photos. This is Yang Cheng Fu. This is Wu Jianquan. This is Sun Lutang. And this is Jai Weichuan. Again, body leaning motion should coordinate with the specific foot posture. These pictures also reflect the Xie Zhong Yu Zheng concept. So, dynamically maintaining body balance is a key aspect of a traditional martial art practice. It is just like a famous quote by many Yi Quan practitioners, quote, 邪正统一，邪即是正，正即是邪。End quote. Translation: Leaning and straightness is unified as one. Leaning is straightness, while straightness is leaning. So, how should you actually practice 邪中意正? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 3: Practice of 邪中意正。No matter what structure, straight or leaning, both of these body structures are meant for combat or self-defense. Or else, it is not necessary to differentiate these two body structures at all. Furthermore, in martial art practice, no matter what style, any body structure is the right structure as long as it is suitable for Fa Jin or power release. As a solo form of practice is aimed to develop martial skills used in self-defense situations. This is the first and foremost point that you should keep in mind in practice. Also, both leaning and straight body structure are worthy of a discussion because we need to identify the right structure for form training. So, a posture is good as long as it is dynamically balanced and enables you to release martial power without blockage. Leaning and straightness are similarly used to differentiate between martial training mechanisms for analysis, but are not the goal of practice. To maintain dynamic balance, certain body areas, especially the hips, should be emphasized in practice. Normally, the side that supports more body weight or the hip closer to the center line should sink more than the other side. Pause this video and give it a try. You will see what I mean. To correctly apply 邪中意正, body leaning should be maintained in the right scope. In other words, the center line of the body should not go beyond the supporting area created by your feet, or else you will not be able to maintain balance. In general, you have to physically test the internal sensation of a different 邪中意正 posture so that the natural leaning motion becomes internal straightness. Internal martial art training is a process of internalization of a different body structures used for different martial expressions. Now, let's look at some important principles of 协中抑症 in the next topic. Topic 4, principles of 协中抑症. The introduction of important principles may seem to further abstract an already advanced concept, but in reality, they only improve the understanding of the said concept.The same is the case with 协中抑症. So, let's talk about the three important principles of 协中抑症 today. They are, first, 协是外形，症是内意. Leaning is the external structure, while straightness is the internal mind. Second, 协是因，症是果. Leaning is the cause, and the straightness is the effect. Third,邪则力猛，正则力沉。Leaning facilitates fierce power, while straightness facilitates thinking power. Let me explain them one by one. First, 邪是外形，正是内意。Leaning is the external structure, while straightness is the internal mind.I borrowed this proverb from calligraphy to express the relationship between structure and energetic feeling. Physically leaning motion is a martial expression of internal straightness. Internal energetic feeling and martial intention are the dominating factors in differentiating between leaning and straightness.Second, 邪是因，正是果。Leaning is the cause, and straightness is the effect. A leaning motion can be applied for strong martial power release. At the same time, straightness is the energetic feeling caused by the leaning approach. Third, 邪则力猛，正则力沉。Leaning facilitates fierce power, while straightness facilitates thinking power. Leaning motion, especially the forward-leaning structure, can dramatically optimize the martial striking effect, while a straight body structure can help sink energy downward. This is why in most of the ending postures of martial movements,The body normally maintains a straight structure since sinking energy is the main objective in practice. So, both body structures are aimed at different objectives in terms of energetic feeling. Now, let's clarify an important misperception of 协中抑症 in the next topic. Topic 5.Misperception of 协中抑症. Any concept, especially an abstract one, can be easily misperceived, and 协中抑症 is no exception. Let me clarify an important one in today's video. Some people in the community believe, quote, 邪就是邪，正就是正, or leaning is just to lean,and straightness is just to be straight. Let me clarify this today. Well, this belief is correct at face value. Of course, leaning or 斜 and 正 or straight are two different words, and they cannot be used to replace each other. So, superficially and literally speaking, this claim is right. However,If we analyze this claim in a martial art context, then it is no longer correct. There is a close relationship between leaning and straightness in martial art practice, which we have already discussed. Mechanically separating the relationship between these two terms in martial practice is incorrect. At an advanced level,Leaning and straightness serve different purposes and should be managed systematically. In other words, unifying leaning and straightness in practice, is both a challenge and an objective for an experienced martial artist. Topic 6, demonstration. Today, I'd like to demonstrate a Chen style Tai Chi form. That is the Liu Feng Si Bi. In that small form, I will emphasize the Xie and Zheng, or leaning and straightness. In order to better demonstrate the concept, I will exaggerate some aspect of the small form. Okay, let me demonstrate the Liu Feng Si Bi without emphasizing on the straight and the leaning motion, okay? So just like straight motion. Now I emphasize the leaning motion in the straight the practice. Topic 7, correction of a student's practice. Okay, now let my students demonstrate a small part of the Xing Yi rooster movement. Then I correct his the practice, and hopefully he makes some improvement. 2, 3, 4. Again. Okay, so let me correct his some movement. You just from here. First of all, the first movement, right? So make sure weight on the back leg, then extend forward. Then the palm relax, then punch. Punch me, right? Punch, so it's like this, right? So this more movement. So block then here, again. One, do not look back. Then after, before you move, stand back. One, two. Then two, one, move back. Here, turn like this, relax here. No, relax, why are you so tense? So two. And then the back knee push upward. Yes, look forward. And then the shoulder move downward. Yes. And then the palm relax here. Because here relax also. Two. Then this movement, right? Make sure continue. So after here, one, go further, do not. Yes, and over the head. One, and then finger release gradually. One. Yes, then two, make sure finger point forward, keep this posture while you point for body sink down, and then palm do not face, finger point upward, like this, then nice movement when you go forward, extend, and continue. So don't look at me, okay, first overhead, second, under the elbow. Third, the back here extend outward. Yes. Again, from beginning. Slowly. One, two, extend. Three, four. Finger point forward. Both hand, four. Then, elbow over the knee, palm here. Coordinate. Then here, extend the back a little bit like this. Head up. Yes, it's good. Thank you. Topic 8, takeaways. First, balance in Chinese culture is an important and fundamental concept. It implies dynamic balance and not merely maintaining a physical symmetry. Second, martial art and Xie Zheng Yi Zheng. Leaning in straightness is an abstract but practical solution in martial training, which can help practitioners improve the ability to dynamically maintain balance. 3. To correctly apply Xie Zheng Yi Zheng, certain body areas, especially the hip area, should be adjusted to better suit the structure. Also, body leaning should be maintained in the right scope. In other words, the center line of the body should not go beyond the supporting area created by your feet, or else you will not be able to maintain balance. First, three important principles of 斜中抑症are: first, 斜是外形，正是内意。Leaning is the external structure, while straightness is the internal mind. Second, 斜是因，正是果。Leaning is the cause, and the straightness is the effect. Third, 斜则力猛，正则力沉。Leaning facilitates the fierce power, while straightness facilitates sinking power. Fifth, a very common misperception for 斜中抑症 is 斜就是斜，正就是正。Oh, leaning is just to lean, and straightness is just to be straight.Remember, this is a misperception and should be avoided in your practice. That brings us to the end of today's video. A quick reminder to send me your questions in the comments or on the Ask Daoyi Discord channel or via email. Thank you for watching. See you next time and enjoy your practice.